Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. What a privilege, what an opportunity that which God has given us once again this morning on 24th of October, the year 2021. This Sunday morning service, remember, it is our covenant day of family breakthrough and thanksgiving. Just thanking God for giving us this opportunity to be with our families. Remember, the Bible says in the book of Psalms, chapter 118, from verse 24, that this is the day that the Lord has made. I shall rejoice and be glad in it. Remember, at this hour, there is someone that God cannot speak. At this hour, there is someone that God is in the bed. At this hour, there is someone that God is in the hospital. At this hour, there is someone that cannot walk. But God has given you the gift of life. He has given you the gift of walking. He has given you this life. And that's why this morning, the Bible says in the book of Psalms, chapter 100, from verse 4, that enter unto his gates with thanksgiving. And this morning we want to thank him because he's a God of another opportunity. He is a God of another chance. Praise the Lord. Hallelujah. Shall someone lift up your voice as we're going to thank God once again. Father, in the mighty name of Jesus, this morning we thank you for our last Sunday service. In our covenant day of enlargement, indeed, we saw an enlargement upon our life. This morning, we thank you for our midweek service, in our last Friday, in our midweeks and international service. Indeed, we saw your hand in our covenant day of breaking generational curses and raising new altars for Lord in our lives. We thank you. We give you praise. We say there shall be no one like you, Jesus. Your name is above other names. Even for this Sunday service this morning, we are here to say thank you, Jesus. This Sunday morning, we are here to say thank you. Receive all the glory, receive all the honor. Father, in this Thanksgiving service, in our covenant day of family breakthrough, we say thank you. Receive all the praise, receive all the honor. There shall be no one like you, Jesus. We worship you, Lord. We give you the praise. We give you all the honor. There shall be no one like you, Jesus. Your name is above all the names. You alone to be lifted up. You alone to be given all the honor. Masaka sheke zeke zeke ze. Rika shalabas. Mazeke tekete. Rosha kaza. In Jesus' precious mighty name, we do pray and give thanks. Amen. I don't know what you are thanking God for this morning, but I know that God has already answered your prayer in thanksgiving. Praise the Lord. Hallelujah. Praise the Lord. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. This morning again, we're going to pray for our families. We're going to put our families in the hands of the Lord and say this in this manner. Father, in this Sunday service, in our covenant of family breakthrough and thanksgiving, we pray for our families, our marriages, our businesses, our career, and we put them in your hands in the name of Jesus. The Bible speaking in the book of James, chapter 1, from verse 17, therefore marriage should make a man move up on the ladder of progress. It should take him from good to better. We are going to pray that, Father, we pray in every marriage that may you empower the heads of the families, the men that may never be ashamed in their families, in the name of Jesus. Shall we lift our voices and pray? Father, in the mighty name of Jesus, this morning we pray for our marriages, we pray for our families. In this covenant day of marriage and family breakthrough, Father, we pray that may you engage your power, engage with us, speak to us, do a miracle thing in the name of Jesus. Masha Kaseke, Lord, we pray for our family, we pray for our families, we pray for our marriages, we pray for our children. This morning we put them in your hands. We pray that there shall be no one like you, Jesus. Your name is above other names. You alone to be lifted up. You alone to be given all the honor. You alone to be given all the glory. The Kasha Kaze, Maze Kota Kaza, She Sakarebush. Lord Jesus, this morning we honor you, we honor you. We glorify your name. We give you all the praise. In Jesus' precious mighty name, we do pray and believe. Hallelujah. Praise the Lord. Also, this morning we want to pray for the Church of Jesus Christ. We want to pray in this manner. Father, let this church, the Reference Center International, Nairobi, Kenya, never be the same again. In the name of Jesus. In the name of Jesus. We're going to read from the book of Matthew, chapter 16. Bible says in the book of Matthew, chapter 16, from verse 18. Hallelujah. The Bible says, and I say also unto you that you are Peter, and upon this rock I will build my church, and the gates of hell shall not prevail against it. And I will give you unto you the keys of the kingdom of heaven, and whatsoever you shall bind on earth shall be bound in heaven, and whatsoever you shall lose on earth shall be loosed in heaven. This morning we are going to pray that, Father, we pray for this commission that it shall be never the same again, that whatsoever the devil has builded upon it, we break it. No gates of hell shall prevail against it. In the name of Jesus, lift up your voice as we pray. Father, in the mighty name of Jesus, this morning we lift our voices and pray that this morning, the Reference Center International Nairobi will never be the same again. We pray that there shall be no gates of hell shall prevail against it. This Sunday morning, we honor you, we thank you, we glorify your name. We say that you are worthy to be lifted up, you alone to be worshipped. In the mighty name of Jesus, we pray for our service in our online, in our physical church. It shall never be the same again. No gates of hell shall prevail against it. In the name of Jesus, Father, we pray that do something. In the name of Jesus, let your power prevail in our life. In the name of Jesus, Kashiribush, Mazakata. Father, we thank you. We give you praise. We give you all the glory. Blessed be unto your holy name. In Jesus' precious mighty name, we do pray and believe. Someone shout hallelujah. Someone shout hallelujah. Praise the Lord. As you are praying for the Church of Jesus Christ, it shall never be the same again. In the name of Jesus. Praise the Lord. Hallelujah. This morning, once again, I want us to pray. For our lives, our breakthrough in our families, in our businesses, in our career, that any closed door in our life shall be opened, shall not be shut, there shall be no violence in our nation of Kenya. The Bible says in the book of Isaiah chapter 60 from verse 18 that there shall be no more violence in your nation. As this morning we are going to pray, violence is what brings economic challenge. That's why we want us to pray that, Father, there shall be no violence in our families. There shall be no violence in our country. There shall be no violence in every area of our life. In the name of Jesus, lift up your voice and pray. Father, in the name of Jesus, we pray that let no violence be had in our nation. Let no violence be had in our families. Let no violence be had in any area of our life. In the name of Jesus. Mashekezekeze. Marakazete. Yoshakarabababa. Father, this morning we gather in this sanctuary to pray for our church, for our families, for our nation of Kenya. In the name of Jesus, that there shall be no violence in any area of our lives. In the mighty name of Jesus, we pray that appear by yourself. Appear by yourself. Let your presence be present upon our life. In the mighty name of Jesus. Father, we thank you. We give you praise. We give you glory. In Jesus' precious mighty name, we do pray and believe. Hallelujah. As you are praying, there shall be no violence in our life. There shall be no failure in our life. We shall succeed in our businesses, in our career, in the name of Jesus. Praise the Lord. Lastly, we are going to pray that God may you supply according to your will. In the name of Jesus, in our family, in our business, in our career. Father, let every lack come to an end in our life in the name of Jesus. The Bible says in the book of Philippians chapter 4, verse 19, that I shall supply according to the riches of heaven and according to your glory. This morning, I want us to lift our voices and say, Father, supply in my life to shame my enemies, to shame those who love against me. In the name of Jesus, Father, supply. I want you to lift up your voice and pray like you mean it. that Father, supply, supply in the name of Jesus. Bible says in the book of Philippians chapter 4 from verse 19, but my God shall supply all your needs according to his riches in glory by Christ Jesus. Shall we lift our voices and pray? Father, in the mighty name of Jesus, supply according to your riches in glory upon our life, upon my life, my family, my ministry, my career, in the name of Jesus. Father, any lack in my life, let it be terminated. Let it to come to an end in the name of Jesus. Mashikezekeze, rosha kaza kaza, mareto koja, supply, 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 in the mighty name of Jesus. Father, this morning, I pray that may you open and close the door in my life, in my family, in my ministry, in my career, in my finances, in the mighty name of Jesus. Whatever the obstacle, let it to come to an end in the name of Jesus. Father, we thank you. We give you praise. We give you glory. We honor you. In Jesus' precious, mighty name, we do pray and believe. Hallelujah. This morning, I don't know where you're watching us this time is from, but I pray that whatsoever you commit to God to supply for you, he shall supply it to you in the name of Jesus. Praise the Lord. Father, we thank you. We give you praise. We give you glory. We give you all the honor. Jesus' precious, mighty name, we do pray and believe. Hallelujah. Remember, this morning, it is our covenant day of marital breakthrough in our marriages, families, in the name of Jesus. And also, is our Thanksgiving service, whereby we are going to thank God that he has been faithful unto us all throughout the month of October until today. Remember, God is a God of another opportunity who has done it according to his will in our life. Praise the Lord. That's why this morning, I want to take this opportunity to invite everyone to join us in this service from wherever you are watching us from. Join us this service as we get blessed together in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. Praise the Lord. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Osha kaza kaza. I know that God has prepared something for you. I know that God has prepared something for you. I know that there's something good at which God has prepared for you. And your life will never be the same. And your life will never be the same. In the name of Jesus. In the name of Jesus. Praise the Lord. Praise the Lord. Hallelujah. Shall be permanent what the Lord has done for me. It shall be permanent. Oh, it shall be permanent what the Lord has done for me. Shall be permanent. Our call to worship comes from the book of Psalms chapter 66 from verse 1. The Bible says, make a joyful noise unto God, all you lands. Verse 2, the Bible says, sing for the honor of his name, make his praises glorious. Verse 3, the Bible says, say unto God, how awesome are you in your works. Through the greatness of your power shall your enemies submit themselves unto you. All the earth shall worship you, and they shall sing unto you. They shall sing to you your name, Zera. Come and see the works of God. He is awesome in his doing towards the children of men. He turned the sea into dry land. They went out through the floods on foot. There did we rejoice in him. He ruleth by his power forever. His eyes behold the nations. Let not the rebellious exalt themselves, Sarah. Oh, bless our God, you people, and make the voice of his praise to be heard. Praise the Lord. This morning in our Thanksgiving service, in our covenant day of family breakthrough in marital destiny, I pray for you that God is gonna intervene in your case and your life will never be the same again. In the mighty name of Jesus. Whatever that you have been experiencing as a marriage, you've been looking for a partner, you've been going through violence, but by the power of God in this service, God is gonna restore it. He says in the book of John chapter 2 from verse 25, I will restore what the locust has taken from your life. Whatever that which you have lost, God is here to restore. And I pray that restoration shall be permanent. That restoration shall be permanent in the name of Jesus. Praise the Lord. Allow me to make the following announcement as we move to the next level in the name of Jesus. First announcement, I want to take this opportunity to invite you to join us this morning in this Sunday service in our covenant day of family and marital breakthrough. Also in our Thanksgiving service, that which is ongoing, and God bless you as you join us. Again, our second announcement, I want to invite you to join us in our midweek service every Friday from 10 a.m. to 12 p.m. in our Midrise and International Command Service. And I know in that command service, God shall command His blessings upon your life. Your life will never be the same again in the name of Jesus Christ. Praise the Lord. Also, I want to take this opportunity to invite you to join us in our next Sunday service. It is our prophetic encounter service. It is our prophetic encounter service, our covenant day of fulfillment in our prophetic encounter service. Whatever has never been fulfilled in this prophetic encounter service, in our next Sunday service, every prophetic word shall be a word of blessing for you, shall be a word of blessing for your family, shall be a word of blessing for your children, shall be a word of blessing for your career, shall be a word of blessing for your children and for your ministry in the name of Jesus. Praise the Lord. And also, our last announcement, I want you to go to our social media platforms and like our Facebook page and YouTube channel, Robbie TV Africa, Dr. Robert Osoro, Prophet Robert Osoro Deliverance Center International. And God bless you so much in all our social media platforms. God bless you for doing so. Subscribe and like and follow us, and God bless you in the name of Jesus. Praise the Lord. Hallelujah. This morning, I want to take this opportunity, wherever we are, to give unto the Lord our offering this Sunday service. Remember, it is our Thanksgiving service. You can give your Thanksgiving offering, your prophetic offering, your love offering, your will offering, whatever the offering that which God has given you this morning. The Bible speaking in the book of Luke chapter 6 from verse 38. That give and it shall be given unto you, the same measure that you measure shall be measured unto you. Praise the Lord. This morning, distance is not a barrier. I don't know where you're watching us this service from, but one thing that which I believe, that God shall connect you to your destiny helpers, and your life will never be the same again in the name of Jesus. Praise the Lord. Remember, we are giving to our church till number, which is 902-6443. We are giving to the church till number. This is 902-6442-3. And also, you can give all to M-Pesa number 072-699-6302. Lift up your offering as we're going to pray. Father, in the name of Jesus, this morning we gather in your presence. And Father, we know that you're not in need of our finances. You're not in need of our giving, but we are in need to connect to you for a financial breakthrough, for the blessings that which you have packaged for us this morning. That as we give our thanksgiving, as we give our will offering, our prophetic offering, our sacrifice offering this morning, engage upon us in the name of Jesus. Father, we thank you. I pray for someone that who has lifted that hand, that hand will never go down the same way it came, but shall be a blessed hand in the name of Jesus. Father, we thank you. We give you praise. We give you glory. We give you all the honor. In the name of the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit. I pray that offering is blessed. That lifted hand is blessed. I speak supernatural power upon your life in the mighty name of Jesus. And whatsoever has never worked in your life, it shall start to work. You shall receive a financial breakthrough. You shall receive a lifting in your family. Whatever that family has been gone through by the power of God shall come to an end in the name of Jesus. Praise the Lord. As we are going to give unto the Lord, remember our till number is 902-6443. And I pray that your family is taking a new turn in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. Praise the Lord. Hallelujah. Praise the Lord. This morning, as we had purposed, we shall be speaking on the topic entitled, Hallelujah. Remember, it's our covenant day of family breakthrough. It's our covenant day of our family breakthrough. And I shall be speaking on the topic entitled, Understanding the Basic Truths About the Family. Understanding the Basic Truths About the Family. Praise the Lord. Understanding the basic truths about the family for a breakthrough encounter. Understanding the basic truths about the family for a breakthrough encounter. Praise the Lord. Hallelujah. You are welcome back to the family life where God is happy to every family. Praise the Lord. God is the ordainer of any marriage to work. Praise the Lord. Someone may ask me, what is marriage? Marriage is between two people of the opposite sex that comes from different perspective to make one mission or vision to be accomplished. Praise the Lord. And that vision always is life. That vision always is about life. Praise the Lord. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Praise the Lord. I know that whatever that you have been going through over your life, it has come to an end. A new beginning is starting in your life in the name of Jesus Christ. That one thing that has been a trouble, have been a challenge over your marriage, over your business, over your children, by the power of thanksgiving in this covenant day of family and marital breakthrough, it is coming to an end and a new beginning is coming to your life in the name of Jesus Christ. Praise the Lord. The word of God says, remember ye not the former things, neither consider the things of the old. Behold, I will do a new thing. Isaiah chapter 43 from verse 18 and 19. Remember not the former things. Whatever that you have been going through, that marriage, that business, that career, whatever, most especially for that marriage, remember not, for God is preparing a new thing for you. Praise the Lord. Hallelujah. Forget about all your past failures, past prayerlessness, and also weakness, spirituallessness, because God has purposed to do something new in your marriage, in your family, in your relationship. He has already prepared a way for you. The Bible says, I will make a way where there's no way. He said that he made a way where there were no way. Praise the Lord. Hallelujah. This year, before the year comes to an end, you need to position yourself for a new things. As you do that, the new things of God shall not pass you by. But as the year ends, it shall end with you. As the year ends, God shall put a package of blessings in your hand for the new beginning of your life. The Bible says, those who mocked you, they shall come to dedicate your marriage and family and children. Those who mocked you, they shall come to celebrate you. Because God's will is to see every family, to enjoy the fruitfulness of every family. And that's why I pray this morning that any family that is going through hell, any family that is going through challenges, by the power of God, that family is restored this morning. I speak as a prophet of God, the apostle of Jesus Christ, that who has been given authority and power to speak over situations to work over your life. Every negative situation that the doctors have given you, that you cannot give birth, that cancer cannot receive healing, that which brings the failure of that marriage, by the power of God has come to an end. And a new beginning is emerging in your life in the mighty name of Jesus. Praise the Lord. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Praise the Lord. This month, as it has come to an end, we have been talking about the topic beginning the new month. Today, we shall be discussing the topic marriage is for God, for better and for best. Praise the Lord. Marriage is for God, for better and for the best, but not for the worst. No. I hear some marriages when most of the officiators or the pastors who officiate them, they say that this marriage will be for better, for bad, for worse. That's nonsense. Every marriage is ordained to be for better. Every marriage is ordained to be for good. Every marriage is ordained to be for better. Praise the Lord. That's why this morning I am praying that any marriage that which is struggling by the power of God, that struggle has come to an end and a new beginning is coming. Because marriage is for good, better, and for best. Praise the Lord. Marriage is not a trap. Praise the Lord. What is marriage? Marriage, it was instituted for the good of man. In the beginning, God saw that it was not good for man to be alone. So he instituted marriage, and the Lord God said, it is not good that the man should be alone. I will make him an helpmeet for him. Genesis chapter 2 from verse 18. I believe God must have said to himself, I want it to be good for man. So I will make him an helpmeet for him. Marriage was ordained and designed to make life great for mankind. Praise the Lord. One of the reasons why God created marriages, it was designed and ordained to make sweet for mankind. Praise the Lord. We understand that every good and perfect gift comes from the Father of lights. Praise the Lord. We understand that every good and a perfect gift comes from the Father of lights. James chapter 1 from verse 17. The Bible says, therefore, marriage should make a man move up on the ladder of progress. It should take him from good to better, from better to base, and from base to the point of perfection in life. There is always a place called forward, which you must strive to get to. Exodus chapter 14, verse 15. Any given moment that you are in that marriage, expect the best, expect the perfection of God. It is God that cook and perfect that marriage to work. It is God that will make it to be perfect. Praise the Lord. Many are scared of entering into marriage because they see it as an instrument of stagnation. Praise the Lord. But marriage is meant to advance, increase, and promote one. And that is why this morning, in this covenant day of marital breakthrough, I'm praying for everyone that who is struggling in the marriage, in a relationship, by the power of the Holy Spirit, that stagnation has come to an end in the name of Jesus. There shall be no marital delay, there shall no marital failure in the mighty name of Jesus. I speak as an oracle of God, the prophet of God and the apostle of Jesus Christ, that who is sent for this generation. Every marriage that experiencing challenges, every stagnation, every separation, every divorce has come to an end and a new beginning is coming to your life. God is opening a new door for you. God is opening a new beginning for your marriage, a new breakthrough for your finances in that marriage and make that marriage to fail in the mighty name of Jesus. Praise the Lord. Hallelujah. Never fear a journey that you have not stepped in. That if I get there, what will come? What if you get there and your life changed for good? Praise the Lord. Always have a positive thought. Always have a positive thought. And this morning, wherever you are watching me from, all reasoning distance is not a barrier. But I am speaking as an oracle of God, a prophet of God, and apostle of Jesus Christ, that your marriage is going for better, for better, for better, and a better, and a better forever in the name of Jesus. Praise the Lord. It is not necessary. Praise the Lord. Evil, as you may have heard and probably believed, rather, it is designed to make life complete for you. A bachelor may say, but life is good for me now. No matter the kind of wonderful experience you may be having now, hear what the Bible says. Two are better than one because they have a good reward for their labor. Praise the Lord. Two are better than one, for they have a good reward for their labor. For if they fall, one will lift up his fellow. But woe to him that is alone, When he falleth, for he had not another to help him up. Again, if two lie together, then they have heat. But how can one be warm alone? Praise the Lord. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. And if one prevail against him, two shall withstand him. Ecclesiastes chapter 4 from verse 9 and 12. Ecclesiastes chapter 4 from verse 9 and 12. Praise the Lord. So marriage is for, marriage is not for boys, but is for a mature man and a woman. Praise the Lord. Marriage is not for boys and girls, but is for mature women and men. Praise the Lord. Marriage provides you an opportunity for better living. Praise the Lord. I used to be scared by the certain marriages foes I hear. Couples chant on the wedding day. They say such a thing as, I so and so get into wedlock with you, for better for worse, in sickness and health. I saw the ignorance of the officiating priests and the intending couples as they chant the so-called marriage vows. Because marriage is not designed to be for better for worse, but for better and better. Any marriage that is designed for better for worse, I cancel that prophetic utterance that you gave in that altar in the name of Jesus. And I open a new door for better and better for you in the mighty name of Jesus. Praise the Lord. As far as God is concerned, marriage is for better living. That is why Deuteronomy chapter 32 from verse 30, the Bible says, how should one chase a thousand and two put them thousands to flight? Jesus reiterated this again and said unto you, that if two of you shall agree on each as touching anything that they shall ask, it shall be done for them of my Father which is in heaven. Matthew chapter 18, verse 19. This must be why God instructs husbands to dwell with their wives according to knowledge, so that their prayers be not idle. Hallelujah. That is 1 Peter chapter 3, verse 7. Hallelujah. Marriage provides a covenant platform for effectual prayer. Marriage provides a covenant platform for effectual prayer. Praise the Lord. Whatever a couple agrees upon in prayer is done for them. Marriage gives you access to double victory. As a couple can put their thousands to flight, also then one party is called. The other is available to warm him up. When one is down, the other will lift him up. The ultimate in marriage is for the best in life, and you will get there. Praise the Lord. I am praying for someone that believing for a better change of story in your marital breakthrough by the power of God. God is going to do something good for you in the mighty name of Jesus. Praise the Lord. Hallelujah. I don't know where you are watching me from, but distance is not a barrier. Wherever you are under my voice, I command every stagnation in your marriage. I command every stagnation in your family, in your children, in your family, in the mighty name of Jesus. Praise the Lord. For better living, marriage is ordained for better living. Praise the Lord. Marriage was instituted for better living for mankind. It is not to bring acts or constitutes or idolizes. Let us take a look at the amplified version of the Bible in the book of Genesis chapter 2 verse 18. Now the Lord God said, it is not good, sufficient, satisfactory, that the man should be alone. I will make him a helpmeet, suitable, adapted, complementary for him. God already ordained marriage and families to be for better. Praise the Lord. And I pray for you that if there's nothing that which is hindering your marriages and families, I pray that let the power of the Lord come upon your family and break them in the name of Jesus. Praise the Lord. The kind of help God intended marriage to provide is one that is suitable, adaptable, and complementary, and it is expected to cover all areas of life. Praise the Lord. If the marriage is in the working position, everything will be in a position to work in your life, in your business, in your career, in your job, whatever that you are doing, it is entitled to work for better. Because marriage is favor. Praise the Lord. Marriage was ordained for spiritual. Hallelujah. Spiritually, God expects you to be a positive influence on your spouse so that you can put place on together to greater spiritual heights. Praise the Lord. A man who does not care about the spiritual state of his wife is not helping her. Perhaps he discovers that a spiritual life is not what it used to or should be. Probably she is weak in prayer, in studying the word and other spiritual matters. He should just fold his hands and concern, watching her life deteriorate. Such a husband is not a helpmate. Praise the Lord. A husband who, rather than help his wife to stay spiritually vibrant, concentrate on himself alone, is selfish. He should know that at the end of the day, what will happen can be likened to the effect of the force of gravity on an object that is drawn up. Very soon, the object will stop going up and start coming down. A wife who is spiritual weak can pull down a spiritual giant of her husband and vice versa. Praise the Lord. And that's why God say it's not good for a man to be alone. I will build him a helpmate. It is a responsibility of a man to make sure the well-being of his family. It is a responsibility of a man to make sure the well-being of his wife. It is the responsibility of a man to make sure the well-being of his children. And when a man takes charge of the family, from the finances, from the well-being of the family, spiritual matters, from the physical matter, psychological matters, then that family, it is aligned and ordained for the success of the Lord. Praise the Lord. Praise the Lord. Shakarabas. Mazeketekete. Yazanta karaba. I speak the power of God upon someone that who is experiencing challenges right now. I don't know where you are watching me this service from, but distance is not a barrier. This Sunday, God is here to change your life. God is here to change your family. God is here to change your state in the mighty name of Jesus. Praise the Lord. So, as you strive to grow in the things of God, make sure you grow along with your spouse. That way, two will be better than one because they are both working towards the same spiritual goal. Praise the Lord. Marriage is for social. Praise the Lord. God expects couples to also help one another socially. For instance, due to your partner background, he or she may not know certain social manners, such as table manners, matching colors, appropriate dressing codes for various occasions. It is your responsibility to educate your spouse on them. The essence of marriage is for couples to help each other. God did not create marriages or bring two together for worse, but for better, to help each other. Praise the Lord. To correct in love. To correct in love. And when you correct your partner in love, but not in complaining, because complainers complicate matters. God is happy of your family. I pray for you, whatever that is an obstacle in your marriage, in your family, in your children, wherever you are right now, receive that breakthrough in the name of Jesus. Receive that new beginning in the name of Jesus. By the power of the Holy Ghost, right now, receive the power of God for a change of soul. In the mighty name of Jesus, praise the Lord. Marriage is ordained for financially. Praise the Lord. God expects a husband and a wife to be financially transparent to one another. They should not keep things away from each other, especially when it concerns money matters. Praise the Lord. When it concerns money matters. In some cultures, the men believe that it is a shameful thing for their wives to know how much they earn. But the truth is, if you hide your earnings from your wife, she will definitely make demands that are beyond your means. As he doesn't know how much you earn, you have to make up your mind whether to hold on to cultures or to hold on the word of God. But I believe by the word of God will set you free to hold in the word of God and to be one. Because the Bible says, and two became one. So there's no secret in two, that we're living together, we're doing things together, because already you have become one. Hallelujah. Praise the Lord. Some women also believe that their husbands alone are responsible for providing for the home. They will even quote scriptures to back up this belief. No wonder when such a woman earn their own money, they hide it from their husbands and make them pay for everything in the home. Wife, don't keep your money for the purpose of buying the latest clothes, shoes, and headgears in town only. You make yourself look like a prostitute when you give your husband your body, but cannot give him your money. Couples are expected to help each other than in every area of life. They are expected to give a circle to each other. Be honest with one another so that your marriage can last. Remember, whatever money you have belongs to both of you. Money has put many homes asunder. Don't let it put you asunder in the name of Jesus. And we are praying for you that as money has become the issue of the family, the God of heaven, he will come and appear before you to pave way for you. And that marriage money will not bring it down, but that marriage will work in the name of Jesus. That pride will come to an end in the mighty name of Jesus. Praise the Lord. Praise the Lord. Hallelujah. I pray for you today that the God of heaven will appear physically before you in the name of Jesus. Marriage is ordained for mankind. Praise the Lord. Adam wasn't created a dose. He was created an intelligence being. How else could he have given names to all the animals in the Garden of Eden? If this mind was not active and alive, the names he gave to those animals are what they still bear today. 1 Corinthians chapter 2, verse 16 tells us, but we have the mind of Christ. God created you with a sound mind. So, in marriage, both the man and the woman are supposed to be mentally sound and alive. Marriage is meant to improve you mentally. The scripture says two are better than one. So, when a sound mind comes in contact with another sound mind in marriage, the two of them will enter a better realm of living. And I pray for you that there shall be a better realm of living in your life, in your family, in your marriage, in your relationship, in the name of Jesus. Praise the Lord. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Before taking decisions about the home, a husband and a wife should first reason things together. Place facts side by side, considering the benefits and the deficits before taking a decision. That way, they will be able to take better decisions. Isaiah chapter 1, verse 18. Praise the Lord. Marriage is meant for physically. Praise the Lord. Husbands and wives are expected to be helpers of one another, physically also. Husband, your wife will definitely sometimes require your masculine attributes to help her get some physical tasks accomplished. Maybe you are moving to a new apartment and there are some heavy items to be moved. Your wife needs your muscles at such a time. Do not absent yourself at such a time in the name of being busy in the office. Be available to help her. I speak the power of God to every marriage that is coming to an end right now, that God shall restore that marriage. God shall bring back that husband, that wife, that who is making that marriage look like an awkward place that nobody is happy or interested to be there in the name of Jesus. Praise the Lord. I pray right now that let the power of the Lord be available and be present upon your marriage right now in the name of Jesus. Wife, there will be times when your husband will need your feminine, mature, praise the Lord, nature to get things done. For instance, he may need you to help massage his legs, back or body after a very busy day at work. Don't claim to be very busy in the kitchen or with the children. Praise the Lord. Please be available. Somebody once said, men are the boys in trousers. Remember marriage, it is meant for better living. Your marriage will keep moving until you get to the best of God in Jesus' name. Hallelujah. In case you have never given your life to Jesus, that is why that marriage is struggling. And Jesus is saying that he needs you in that marriage. Praise the Lord. I don't know what you are experiencing in that marriage. I don't know what people are saying about your marriage. But I am here to pray for you. I stand as a prophet of God, an oracle of God. I send God's word upon the healing of that family, upon the healing of that marriage. Right now, whatever is not working in your family, whatever is not working in your marriage, in your children, in your relationship, by the power of God, by the power of God, right now, I send God's word. I send God's word upon your family. I send God's word upon your children. Right now, any marriage that experiencing challenges, any marriage experiencing failure, any marriage is experiencing stagnation, by the power of God, that marriage shall be restored. By the power of God, I send God's word. The Bible says in the book of Psalms 107, verse 20, that he sent his word, and they were healed, and there were no more distractions. Right now, I send God's word for the healing of that marriage, for the healing of that family, for the healing of that family, in the mighty name of Jesus. Whatever the challenges, right now, they have become to an end in the name of Jesus. Mashakazeke, Roshakaze. Father, we thank you. We give you praise. We give you all the glory. In Jesus' precious mighty name, we do pray and believe. But if you are not born again, remember these blessings will not be part of you until you receive Jesus as the Savior and the Lord over your life. In case you have never given your life or you have never received Jesus, you are not born again. There is no way you can have a better living without Christ. Who instituted marriages? Most of marriages, they are going through hell because you have no Jesus. He says that, I am who I am. Praise the Lord. This comes by the confessing your sins and accepting Jesus as your Lord and Savior. That is what being born again is all about. If you are ready to be born again, please say this prayer after me. Dear Lord Jesus Christ, I come to you today. As a sinner, forgive me of my sins. I believe you died and rose on the third day for my sins. I accept you as my Lord and Savior. Make me a child of God today. Thank you for accepting me into your kingdom. In Jesus' precious mighty name, I pray for you, Father, in the name of Jesus. I speak a word of protection and security upon your children that who have received Jesus as the Lord and Savior over their life. In the name of Jesus. And if whatever that has been bringing them down right now, as they have received the power of God, that thing has come to an end in the name of Jesus. And if you have prayed this simple prayer, you are now a child of God. He loves you and he will never leave you. Read your Bible daily, obey God's words, and seek Christianity fellowship. John chapter 14, verse 21. Only those who are committed to Jesus, his fellowship, that we are entitled for his blessings. And this morning, before we close this service, I know that God has ordained someone for a purpose. God has ordained you for better. God has ordained you for a new heights in the name of Jesus. I want to pray for someone believing for a change of story. You can just send your prayer request to our comment live there in the Facebook Live, Romy TV Africa. You can send to our email, prophetrobertosoro@gmail.com. Send to deliverancecenterinternational@gmail.com. Or you can send to prosperityrobert@gmail.com. You can send also at romytvafrica@gmail.com. Send your message. You can WhatsApp +254 726 996302. And we shall be praying with your prayer. And if you pray this prayer of salvation, also send us a message so that we can learn with you. Look for somewhere that where the God's word is preached and also join the ministry there. Wherever that you are watching me from distance is not empty. This morning I believe that God already has heard your prayer and this morning has done it good for you. And I remind you to join us in our next Friday service from 10 a.m. in our Middle East and the International Command service. And also join us in our next Sunday service in our Prophetic Encounter service from 9 a.m. And God bless you so much. And someone may who joined us already, we have given our offering. I want you to give your offering. Maybe you want to connect that sacrifice for your marriage, for your relationship. You have been believing God for a partner. You have been believing God for a change of story in your partner. You have been believing God for a change of story in your marriage. This is the hour. I want you to give your offering. You can give to our church till number, which is Deliverance Center International. That is the name that will appear, 902. Church till number is 902-6443. Praise the Lord. As you give that offering, God bless you so much. Let me pray for you. Or you can give to M-Pesa number 272-699-6302. God bless you. Our numbers are passing them down in the screens in our Lobby TV Africa. God bless you so much. Let me pray for you. Father, in the name of Jesus, I pray for someone that believing for a change of story. I pray for this offering. I pray that every lifted hand, that family, that marriage will never go down. In the name of Jesus, I speak supernatural healing, supernatural protection upon their marriages, upon their business. In the name of Jesus, Father, we thank you. We give you praise. We give you glory. We honor you. You alone to be lifted up. In Jesus' precious mighty name, we do pray and believe. God bless you as you give your offering in Jesus' name. Let me pray for someone. Father, in the name of Jesus, for someone believing for a change of story. Wherever they are watching us, this service from distance is not a barrier. I speak healing over that family, healing over that marriage, healing over that career. In the name of Jesus, whatever has never worked before that marriage, it shall work. Whatever has never worked in that career, whatever has never worked in that marriage, right now, I speak the power of God to work. I speak the power of God for a change of story. In the name of the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit, amen. God bless you so much. You can go to our social media platforms and like, subscribe, and follow us. Romy TV Africa, Dr. Robert Osoro, Deliverance Center International, and Prophet Robert Osoro. God bless you so much. And surely, God's goodness and mercy shall follow us all the days of our lives. We shall dwell in the presence of the Lord now and forevermore. Amen. Shalom. God bless you so much. Thank you for your time. Shalom. See you.